Hi everyone, my name is Paul and I'm from SkyCiv. And today I'll be explaining what a p-delta analysis is and why it's important and when it should be used. So p-delta analysis is different from a linear static analysis because it's used when there's larger deflections. So if we look at this diagram of this beam, in a linear static analysis, it will apply the loads as if to the undeformed position of the beam, as if it hasn't moved. And then at the end, it will calculate the deformed position. Whereas a non-linear analysis will be applying the loads in an iterative fashion. So the beam might deflect a little bit, and then it will apply the loads a little bit more, and then it will apply the loads a little bit more again. So the point is that it's applying the loads to the deformed position of the beam, rather than the starting or undeformed position of the beam. So a p-delta analysis usually comes into play when you've got those larger deflections. An example of a structure like that would be a multi-story frame that has a lateral load, such as a wind load that's pushing it sideways, and a gravity load, which would be like a downwards load. So in the diagram of this column here, we can see the gravity load is that vertical downwards load, P, and our wind load is the lateral load, V. So on the left, we've got the undeformed position of our column, and on the right, we've got the deformed or deflected position of the column. Now, if we take the sum of moments about the base of the column, we can calculate that moment sum. So this term on the left is V times L. So V being here and the distance being L. So that's the moment about the base. And then we have the secondary moment, which is caused by the gravity load and the deflection. So the axial load plus the deflection gives us this secondary moment. So that's P multiplied by the distance from the base of the column, delta. And that's our secondary moment, and that's called our P delta effect. So if a p-delta analysis is so great, why don't engineers use it all the time? So one of the downsides with a p-delta analysis is that it can take a little bit more time for the analysis to run. Plus, engineers like to make assumptions and simplify the problem as much as possible. So if it's not necessary, an engineer will usually omit that from the analysis. But it is a really fantastic idea, once you've done making all the iterative changes to the model, to do a p-delta analysis at the end to ensure that there's no significant p-delta effects in the model. Now the last thing that I wanted to mention is that there's usually two types of p-delta effects that get confused or people muddle up. So there is a p big delta and then a p little delta. Now p big delta is the secondary moment that we've mentioned so far. And P little delta is usually a smaller P delta effect, and it's involved when the bending of the member changes the axial force in the member changes the bending stiffness of the member. So I hope that explains why P delta analysis is so important and why a non-linear analysis should be considered during the modeling process. If you have any questions, just leave a comment below, and as always, feel free to get in touch with us. Thanks.